Watching my 8-year-old daughter build this, a $200 custom lightsaber at Disneyland's new Star Wars Galaxy's Edge land, may have made my wallet cry, but it was so cool for her. It is genuinely an experience for the participants, one of the most impressive ways Galaxy's Edge successfully brings Star Wars to life. And my daughter, who's seen the original trilogy and listened to the audiobook renditions of all the movies countless times, ate it up. After we left Savi's workshop with her new toy in hand, she naturally wanted to walk around the park with it. And so we sought out the pair of stormtroopers that roam the land, follow them around, and tried to get noticed. Her goal was for me to get arrested by the soldiers because she'd seen it happen to other guests. So I unsheathed the radiant blue beacon and stood near the stormtroopers with it lit up, pressed against my back, with the blade peeking up over my shoulder so as to intentionally be poorly concealing it. No dice though, the stormtroopers just strolled on by. But then a cast member from Disney approached me and mumbled something or other about keeping my scrap metal out of sight. Huh? I wasn't really sure what he meant. See, the employees in Galaxy's Edge all try to stay in universe, meaning purchases are made in credits, etc., etc. But as we roamed Star Wars land, still seeking out stormtroopers to get joshed by, day had turned to dusk, and this bright blue lightsaber now really stood out. And soon another cast member came over and, in slightly plainer terms, told us the blades were illegal here in the Black Spire outpost, and hammered home his point by helping me secure the lightsaber in its case as I finally grasped his point. Look, I get it. Disney doesn't want its guests spontaneously breaking out into lightsaber duels in the middle of Galaxy's Edge and potentially stabbing another random parkgoer in the eye. But for an 8-year-old kid to not even be able to walk around with the darn thing out when all around you is the most elaborate celebratory recreation of Star Wars ever open to the public just feels like it goes against the spirit of the entire park. This is in pretty stark contrast to the Wizarding World of Harry Potter at Universal Studios, where you can spend $48 at Ollivander's and walk out with a wand that you're encouraged to brandish all about, and that in fact triggers interactive effects hidden throughout Hogsmeade and Diagon Alley. It's really cool how Universal builds in things to do with the wand at the park. Disney should do the same. But we didn't let that stop us from enjoying the ultimate Star Wars souvenir. We walked around Galaxy's Edge and started taking photos with her proudly wielding the lightsaber in the area's many photo spots. And you should know that normally my daughter is not one to smile for the camera, but she had a ball with this lightsaber. You could just see on her face how much fun she was having. Maybe if we're lucky, by the next time we come back, Disney will have wised up and offered some kind of outlet, a lightsaber training class, perhaps, for people to enjoy Disneyland's priciest souvenirs. Because I'll tell you, we are absolutely gonna bring this thing back with us. It's too cool not to. For more on all things Star Wars, keep it tuned right here to IGN.